Hello, welcome to the self-learning podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start discussion on Unit 7, Components of Decentralized Development, Equal Distribution of Benefits of Development. And our topic is factors influencing people's preference for distribution in small groups. Factor influencing people's influencing for distribution. Having also seen why a theory of justice or equal distribution needs to be grounded in evidence about how people understand distributive justice, we must now shift the evidence to see how people understand distributive justice in different circumstances and situations. Researchers have been interested in how distributive justice is understood in small group contexts or in justice across whole society. In the same way, they have been concerned with the belief about justice, what people will say is just or fair, or with people's behavior when asked to allocate some valuable resources. In small group settings, it is possible either to ask people to assess a distribution, say, a distribution of rewards following the carrying out of some task by the members of the group, or to perform the distribution themselves. On a society-wide scale, we can examine belief by, for instance, presenting people with different areas of income distributions and asking them how fair they think they are. And we can examine behavior by looking at how institutions do in practice allocate resources. Each approach has its strength and its weaknesses as a way of getting at what people really think about justice. When focusing on expressed beliefs, we risk picking up they ought to hold according to some imbibed theory, as opposed to the operational beliefs that would guide them in a practical situation. If behavior is the focus, then we are likely to find mixed motive at work, with the attempt to do justice contaminated, for instance, by self-interest. Thus, an allocator in the small group situation may distort justice to get more reward himself. Again, pay scales in industry usually represent a compromise between what they may generally be regarded as fair reward differential between the workers with greater or lesser skills and responsibilities and the bargaining power wielded by different sections of the workforce. When we turn to the contrast between justice within groups and justice across societies, small group research gives the researcher the greatest freedom to exclude the unwanted influences. But it also raises the question as to how relevant distributive decisions in small groups are to wider questions of social justice. Do people in fact use the same criteria when allocating resources among two or three individuals as they do when assessing? Let us say the justice of a capitalist economy. Generally, it has been found that the people may apply one criteria of justice when considering how resources are allocated individual by individual, and another criteria when looking at the overall distribution that results For example, an allocation that gives each person what he or she deserves may be judged to be excessively inegalitarian overall. The micro considerations at stake here may be not necessarily be considered of justice. However, they may, for instance, involve an ideal of society equality that is independent of justice. On the other hand, looking directly at beliefs about macro justice runs the risk of introducing too much contextual constraint into the answers that people give. For instance, if we ask people what an ideally fair distribution of income across society would be, their answers may be influenced by their perceptions of the current distribution. Or if we ask them what responsibility society has to meet people's needs, they may base their answers on existing welfare practices. Let us move to the next point, micro level groups. There has been a lot of research at the micro level on the factors influencing people's preference for distribution according to the desert on the one hand or equality on the other. In a typical scenario, a number of people engaged in some activity have made contributions of different sizes, and respondents are asked to allocate income or other rewards, or to say what they think a fair allocation would be. Sometimes subjects are made to believe that they are participants themselves. Sometimes they are simply asked to make an external judgment. These factors appear to operate through the perceived character of the group within which the distribution is to take place. To the extent that the group is seen as made up of independent individuals whose relationships to one another are simply instrumental, the desert principle is employed. To the extent that the group solidarity emerges, the preferred distribution is shifted towards equality. Asked to allocate bonuses to successful performers, people will opt for a greater degree of equality in the team case. The assumptions are presumably is that joint activity creates a degree of camaraderie that makes greater egalitarianism appropriate. Similar results are found when subjects are given work tasks that are either competitive or cooperative in nature. Moreover, it can be shown that the experience of working cooperatively tends to shift people who originally favor the contribution principle towards greater support for equality. There is a basic underlying belief that the fairness requires that when the size of contributions depends on each person's efforts, people who make less effort should receive less rewards. Two further factors help to shift the criteria of distribution from desert towards equality. One is expectations about how long the group will remain in existence. Temporary groups tend to favor the contribution principle, whereas people who expect to interact with their partners in the future are more favorably disposed. towards equality. The other is discussion within the group, groups who are permitted to decide for themselves which distributive principle to adopt are more likely to favor equality. It has also been found that there is an underlying contrast between groups that are made up of separate individuals, either competing with one another or having merely instrumental relations, and groups in which there is a sense of common identity and solidarity. For groups of the first kind, justice is done when what each takes out is proportional to what he or she has put in. Groups of the second kind, by contrast, see equal distribution regardless of inputs as appropriate. However, it is not clear thus far whether equality is being valued per se or whether it is being used as a proxy for distribution according to need. This general result also has an interesting converse, namely that when asked to choose the principle of distribution, they think most likely to realize specified group goals. People who are instructed to raise efficiency, productivity, and so on will suggest the contribution principle. Whereas those asked to promote group harmony and good working relations will opt for equality. Thus, the distributive principle chosen not only reflects the character of group relations, but also helps to constitute those relations for the future. Thus far, we have looked at factors affecting the desired equality choice without specifying the practice besides basis of desert that is being used. Some experimental studies have, however, attempted to isolate the aspect or aspects of contribution thought to deserve reward. Usually, distinctions are made among ability, indicating the talents or capacities someone brings to a performance, efforts expended, and the performance itself, indicating how much is actually produced or achieved. It is interesting to compare these empirical findings with the prevailing views of political philosophers on the subject of desert. It is a common view among philosophers that people can generally deserve only on the basis of features such as effort that are subject to their voluntary control. There is also the alternative position that although the people must be responsible for their performances in order to be deserving, the performance that forms the basis of desert may also require personal characteristics such as native ability and opportunity that are not voluntarily chosen. Now let us wind up the session and take rest. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with the self-learning podcasts.